there, dear fellow oboists and colleagues. I would like today to do a little comparison between staples. Thanks to the new invention by KGe, we have a really, really huge advantage now as oboe players, and we can try all the staples one by one. I have here a display of several of them. I have the two new bocals. One is silver plated, the other is golden plated, both by KGe. I have a KGe 3 here, and Chiarugi number 2, rust, and another Chiarugi number 2. All of them 47. Except the two bocals, which are named KGe 1 45, the silver plated one, and is the KGe 2, if I don't remember badly, the also 45. Yeah. If we see here, they are the same length. Yeah. So the first staple we have here is the KGe number 2, which is the staple we use to profile, to scrape the reeds, all right? So here we have the reeds, the vocal reed. We mount in the staple, this is another staple. We mount it, all right? If there is some leaking, like is the case, not too much, but just a little bit, we can use a good old plastic here. Yeah, make sure your length is about 72 if you're playing 47, right? Like is the case. Yeah, it's sealing good. I just profiled, scraped this reed with a KGe profiling machine. This one, it's the French model 18. Okay, it's a 0.18. All right, I just did it, it's a smooth. It works quite well in all registers. You can have a smooth staccato and quite good legato. So now this was the KGe number 2. Now let's go with the Chiarugi 2 47 brass. Quite simple. I think I was using for a long time. All these years is one of my favorite staples. Yeah, I mounted the reed in between something like 71.5. Let's yeah, it's smooth. I think it is working quite well. It has a different color. It has a different tone quality, but it's yet working equally balanced in all registers. Okay, so with this kind of simple tool, a new tool, we detach the reed. Okay, now let's try the other KGe 2. You many of you might use it. And let's try to measure it. Yeah, it's about 72. 71 and 72. 71 and a half. Yeah. Seems okay. It's not leaking. This staple, I think the plus it has is like in the high register. Well, this probably has some water or something in the C sharp trill hole. In the high register, it works pretty nicely. It's quite powerful. Probably you cannot hear because it's a little video in my bedroom. I think improved some things, but the tone quality, yet I prefer the other one. It's a slightly darker, slightly smoother. All right. Then we have this KG3. I couldn't find a free one. Let's see if it's. Let's put, anyways, the plastic here, okay? KG3 immediately has this balance response. I think it's a quite well-balanced staple and a good alternative to Chiarugi 2 because it's equally in tune. It's quite in tune in all registers, which is quite important to me at least, and especially the C and the G. I must say, I'm playing a KG Premier here. This oboe particularly has not the problem with the middle C or the low G. It's quite in tune. It shouldn't be a big trouble. Okay, now let's try the silver plated vocal. In this case, the measurements they change quite a bit, and it should be something like between 7 to 69, depending on your tuning. All right, we achieve something like 69. And again, let's apply some plastic. Sealing quite well. About the new vocal staple or the new vocal, it's that it's very, very smooth. Everything, it seems that it sounds a little bit less, but in the end, uh-huh. I think all octaves and all registers are quite well balanced. And I think in the really high register it works pretty nicely. And the amazing thing is, like, all registers are they have a similar tone quality, okay? Yeah, it's quite nice to play and has always this smooth a smooth response, all right. Yeah, it's very nice. It's very nice. I suggest you to try, and I think you all will get surprised. Mm-hmm. Now let's go with the golden one, okay? It's the jewel, little jewel on the crown. We shall measure again. Don't think it's very, very easy, eh? It's very easy to mount it. It's very easy to put it together. It's quite reliable. It doesn't happen like with the English horn. You know, sometimes it can happen that you can somehow detach the reed from the instrument if you bite. It can happen. No, it's not the case. It's not the case. I'm just placing the plastic because, I don't know, I just don't want to be losing time, you know. But usually it doesn't leak air, that's a good thing. Very nice to play, very easy response, all registers well balanced. Well, I didn't play very loud, but I think. I think you can have a nice dynamic range in all the instruments. Okay, thank you guys, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope it clarifies. Again, I was comparing the KG2, KG3 staple, Chiarugi 47, this model, Chiarugi 47 to, what is the other model? this other model, the Bocal, the new Bocal by KG, the silver one and the golden one, okay? Everything was done right now. That's the reason I decided, because I was just making some reeds, you know, Saturday morning, with a new Bocal reed already. Probably in another video I can explain how to mount it, okay? It's pretty easy, pretty intuitive, all right? I hope clarified something in terms of sounding. And again, I was using the KGe Premier. It's a professional model, one of the top. This is wooden one. Very nice response, all equally well balanced. Yep. So if you have any questions, please leave your comments below. Hope you see you in the next video. Thank you.